Welcome back, my friends, to the IroncladLion channel. How do we upgrade Starsector for next-generation hardware? How do we get large battles with more than 10 FPS? How hard do we pray to the Java gods that everything just works? In this video, we'll be going over how to upgrade Starsector's Java version, increase RAM allocation, and edit a few settings for an optimal experience. But first, a little history. Starsector began development right around 2010, with initial public release in 2013, the Corvus system being the entire playable area of the game. We've come a long way since then. However, Starsector has been developed on Java, version 7. While Java has not exactly aged well with time, that hasn't stopped Starsector development. It'd be far too costly to switch game engines, if not impossible at this point, so Starsector will forever be on Java. So the best way in which I can describe what we are about to do is, we're going to overclock Starsector. If that sounds intimidating.
This is where you gotta push past your limits. If you don't, then your path ends here.
Thanks, Yami, but it's really quite easy, and we're gonna work through it step by step. To start our adventure in upgrading Java, let's open up our Starsector folder. You may have this folder in your C, D, or whatever drive your games are in. This folder has the game executable file, mod folder, and the Java or JRE folder. Before we do anything, let's rename our JRE folder to JRE7. This way we have the stable 7 version as backup. This folder won't cause any problems and can safely hang out in our Starsector folder. What we'll be doing now is upgrading to Java version 8. But not just any version 8, specifically update 271. This version of Java has been tested and is in fact compatible with Starsector. To acquire this version of Java, however, can be tricky. You can find JRE8 v271 on a variety of sites. You can download from the Oracle website, which is the official site of Java. You'll just need to make an account. You can also download it from this Verizon link or from FileHorse, which also hosts the version we need. Choose whichever you feel comfortable with. Just remember to select the appropriate version for your system. I'm going to download this FileHorse version so you can follow step by step. I'm using Windows 64-bit, which most of you are probably on. If you are on Linux, you'll need the appropriate version. If you are on Mac, I suggest a different operating system. So we've got our .exe download. File size should be right around 80 megabytes. But before we click on that, I'm going to delete my previous JRE8 folder. Notice how I have my JRE7 folder as backup. Now we'll open up that .exe to begin installation. Make sure you have Java SE Runtime Environment and the verified publisher Oracle America. All good to go. Next, we should have a Java setup window, and we'll want to make sure to change the destination folder. That'll be crucial. We're going to put this Java directly into our Starsector folder, as that is what the game will use. Make sure to create a fresh JRE folder for the installation. Installation should take less than a minute. Let's open up that folder to confirm the installation. It should look very similar to our JRE7 folder. Some of these files are just legal stuff that aren't necessary, but make sure not to touch the bin or lib folders. Before we can launch Starsector, there's a crucial setting that needs to be changed, so let's do that now. In your Starsector folder, open up Starsector Core, Data, Config, then the Settings, JSON file. There's a variety of programs you can use to open these files. I prefer to keep it simple and use Notepad. The settings config file has a ton of settings to tweak your game, so be careful while you are in here. We need to scroll down to Allow Any Java Version and set that to True. By default, it'll be set to False. This entry is located right above the hashtags, but let's assume you get lost while you are in here. You can use Control plus F if you are on Windows to bring up the Find tool. This tool is incredibly helpful, and I suggest you add it to your arsenal. As for what to find, you could type in the full Allow Any Java Version with no spaces, or you can just type Java, then Find Next. This will take us directly to the line we're looking for. So to confirm, change the setting from False to True and save the document. That will allow Starsector to use the newly acquired Java version 8. If you do not change this setting, Starsector will fail to launch, as it does not recognize a usable Java version. With our config file in order and Java 8 installed, we can now boot up Starsector. You may or may not notice a difference in loading times after this upgrade. The main areas in which I notice performance increases are over long play sessions, and especially saving times. Before we move on, you can easily switch your Java version by renaming the JRE folders. Starsector will use whichever folder is labeled as JRE. If you ever get confused or rename your folders incorrectly, you can check the version by opening the release file. This is what your Java version 7 should look like. Meanwhile, your Java version 8 should look like this. Also, I cannot stress enough that you do not want the latest Java 8 version. You want the 2.7.1 update, not v3.8.1 or whatever else you might find online. If you see someone post that they found a newer, better version, don't believe their lies. Congrats on upgrading to Java 8. It's time to turn up the RAM. And how do we go about doing that? It's actually all contained within the vmparams file in your Starsector folder. This is a very important file that can dramatically change the performance of your game. Much like the other files, we can open it with a simple text editor. This file, however, has an unintuitive layout and is entirely written in a single line. This is required. If you think you are being fancy by reorganizing this file, it won't work and Starsector will fail to launch. The order and layout must be exact. So what are the most important bits of vmparams we'll be changing? The XMS and XMX parameters. I don't remember what the Starsector defaults are, but we'll want to increase these numbers if we have more available RAM. These numbers can be increased by multiples of 1024, as there are 1024 megabytes in a single gigabyte. I recommend pulling out a calculator depending on your system. So what's the ideal amount of RAM to allocate? Ideally, you'll want 8 gigabytes of RAM, as that is the maximum amount that Java can reasonably handle. 8 gigabytes is 8,192 megabytes, and is what I have allocated in my settings. This, however, is assuming you have 16 gigabytes of RAM in your system. If you only have 8 gigs on your system, I'd recommend 4 or 6 allocated gigs. 4 being the stable amount, with 6 being the overclocked and less stable option. This is because it's not recommended to allocate more than half your system's RAM to Starsector.
But Ironclad, I'm part of the PC Master Race and have 32 or more gigs of RAM. Can I allocate more than 8 gigs?
Yes, my friend. Yes, you can. This is 16 gigs, or half my currently available RAM. Usable, but may impact performance. And this, well, this is what allocating 30 gigs of RAM to Starsector looks like. It just works. Although, it doesn't work well. And from my experience, doesn't actually make the game perform any better. In fact, it often results in stuttering and sometimes crashing the game entirely. So, even with 32 gigs at my disposal, I have my vmparams set to use 8 gigs. You can increase allocation at your own discretion, but start at 8 gigabytes for stability. As for the XSS parameter, don't fucking touch it. It stands for stack size. I don't know what that really means, but I know that if you change it, bad things happen. So give that short stack a head pat and let's move on. As for the perm size, these are important. I don't know exactly what these mean either, but they prevent memory leaks.
And memory leaks are bad, okay?
Everything past max perm, once again, don't touch it. As for the compiler thread priority, it's not essential, but I've heard that it helps with stability. Otherwise, don't touch anything else, and don't change the order of these. It makes mustard gas. To summarize, I've used these settings for years, and have enjoyed a very stable, smooth Starsector. Someone who knows and understands more about these settings are invited to explain each in the comment section. If you have a brain as smooth as your desired FPS, you can copy my entire vmparam settings and paste it into your own. I'll have it posted in the description box of the video. So we've done our upgrades and are ready to play some unhinged Starsector. But wait, there's more! To fully enjoy our new settings and Java, there's one more number we need to change in the settings file. Once again, we go Starsector Core, Data Config, then Settings. Search for Max Battle, and that should take us right to the line we are looking for. I believe this will be 400 by default. Change that to 1000. To clarify, this will not actually change the in-game value to 1000. This will only allow the in-game slider to go up to 1000, giving you more freedom. Once you're in the main menu, hit the Settings button, Settings tab, and go down to the Battle Size slider. By default, the max battle size should be at 400, but you'll notice that you can drag this bar all the way to 1000. You can set this to whatever you'd like, as it depends on what your system can handle and personal preference. I find 400 quite limiting, so I recommend you try 600 or more with the new settings. With 1000, be prepared for massive battles. If you are still getting low FPS in battles, I highly recommend recommend the Fast Engine Rendering mod by Tomato Paste. While not required by any means, this simple mod can dramatically increase your FPS by changing the way engine plumes are rendered in-game. I'm using it on my current 0.96 playthrough and it works like a charm. All that needs to change is the game version number in the mod info JSON file. Type in what you see on screen and you'll be good to go. I featured this mod in my top 50 list, and yet I'm still surprised at how little attention it gets, given how big of an impact it has on performance. Consider trying it. It's even safe to add and remove mid-playthrough. You could also consider, subscribing to the channel. Now, I don't like asking people to do that, so instead, let's make a deal. You subscribe and help support my humble channel, and I will keep the links to the Java 8 downloads and other information up to date. So no matter how many years pass, you can reliably return to this video for the downloads you need. For while I remain imperturbable and recommence video production, we've got some rookie numbers that need bumping up. I'm interested to hear what kind of effect these upgrades have on your game. Share your experiences and any other useful information down in the comments. If you are a perceptive individual, you might be wondering, why hasn't Alex switched Starsector over to Java 8 officially? Fun fact, he did. But as it turns out, developing in Java 8 is different than playing in Java 8, and so the game was rolled back to the stable Java 7 version. What that means is that upgrading to Java 8 will remain unofficial for the foreseeable future, and each Starsector player must make the upgrade themselves. Gone, however, are the days of pain, suffering, and piecing together outdated information. I hope this guide may unite the player base as a compendium of knowledge for those looking to better their Starsector experience, which wouldn't be possible without the generous donations of the Iron Trading Company. They fuel the fires of the forge and give me purpose in the sector. Each one of them is a truly amazing person that deserves a medal. A really big fucking medal. Thank you, Starsector community, for the continued support of the channel. This one is for you. I'm IroncladLion, and thanks for watching. Imperturbable. Imperturntable. Implap plap plappable.